Hello friends, so in this session let us have a look on prime series program. That means we need to find the number of prime numbers in between the given range, that means 1 to n. So user have to give an input of n value, so that we have to find the prime numbers in between 1 and n. So this is the program for prime series. So this is also similar to our prime number program. That means we have to use the mod operator and we have to find out the factors. So for every prime number there will be only two factors, that is 1 and 0. So at the end we have to check the value of a variable, that is a flag or any count. So if that flag, that particular flag or a counter must be incremented whenever the condition becomes true. That means mod operator, we have to use a mod operator to find the factor. So if that mod operation is equal to 0, that means we have to increment the flag or counter variable. So finally we have to check for the counter or a flag, so that if that flag or a counter is equal to 2, then only we can say that the given number is a prime, because only the prime numbers will be having the factors 2, that is 1 and n. So here we have to repeat the process for all the numbers from 1 to n, same process from 1 to n. So let us take that. So in the previous prime number program, we have taken the representation as n mod I, where I ranges from 1 to n. So 1, n mod 2, n mod 3, n mod 4, and so on, n mod n. Now we have to take this also as a loop variable, because we have to check 1 mod 1, 1 mod 2, sorry, 1 mod 1 and 2 mod 1, 2 mod 2, 3 mod 1, 3 mod 2, 3 mod 3, 4 mod 1, 4 mod 2, 4 mod 3, 4 mod 4, and so on till the n numbers. So for this we have to take both as a loop variables. We have to take this as a loop variable and this one as a loop variable. This is also a loop variable. So we can represent it as I mod j, where I ranges from 1 to n and j ranges from 1 to n. I ranges from 1 to n and j ranges from 1 to n. So after completion of this loop variable, immediately we have to write the next loop. So this will be the outer loop, this will be the inner loop, because for every I value we have to check all the values from 1 to n. So here see, if you consider this 3 mod 3, then only we have to increment the I value. So that means this will be the outer loop and this will be the inner loop. And the remaining logic is same. So we have to check for the condition, mod operator. And if this condition becomes true, that means if this mod operator is equal to 0, we have to increment one variable. So we will finally check the value of that variable for 2. So if that variable is true, the number is prime, or if that variable is not a true, that prime, that number is not a prime. We need to display the numbers. So hope you understood this concept. Let us write the program and trace it, so that you have if you are having any doubts, those doubts will be cleared. Now let us write the program for this prime series. A simple logic. Header file, include the header file. Use the main function. N value, inner outer loop. J for inner loop. Some flag. We need to take the flag. Now read the n value. So enter n value. and scanf. For reading, we have to use the scanf function. So %d, because it is a integer data type, ampersand m. So now we are having the n value. So after reading the n value, we have to use the inner loop and outer loop. Now let us write the outer loop. For I is equal to 0, sorry, we have to start from 1. I less than or equal to n, I plus plus, and write the inner loop. For j is equal to 1, j less than or equal to n, j plus plus. Write down the logic. So we have to check for the condition. So if I mod j is equal to 0, increment the flag. Flag is equal to flag plus 1, or simply we can write it, we can use the increment operator flag plus 1. So close this and close the inner for loop, and if it is satisfies, that implies I is a prime number. So write down, if flag is equal to 2, printf %d is prime. So here the %d is I. Else printf %d is not prime. And close the outer for loop and close the main function. So this is a simple example, sorry, simple program for finding the prime series. That means finding out the all the prime numbers in between 1 and n. So let us trace here. If n is equal to 7, so we have to find all the prime numbers between 1 and 7. So let us start here. N is equal to 7. For I is equal to 1. So I is equal to 1. The loop, the control will enter into the loop. Again there is a loop, that is j is equal to 1. 1 less than n. I mod, so 1 mod 1 is equal to 0. So the condition satisfies. Now flag will be 1. So here flag will be 1. And again, so it is the end of the inner loop. So again j will be incremented. Now j is equal to 2. Right? J is equal to 2. 2 less than or equal to 1. So here 2 less than or equal to 1. The condition fails. So here the condition fails. So automatically the control comes out from the for loop and I will be incremented now. So I is equal to 2. And I is equal to 2. 2 less than or equal to 7. So condition is 2. Control enters into the loop. Now again j is equal to 1. So j is equal to 1. 1 less than or equal to 7. The condition is 2. So here instead of writing n, we can write it as j less than or equal to i, right? So two, here j is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 2, condition is true. So I mod j, that means here I value is 2, j value is 1. So 2 mod 1 is equal to 0. So condition is true. So flag is 1. So here initialize the flag to 0, so that for every iteration the flag will be 0. So here flag 1, condition fails. Again now flag will be initialized to 0. So now the condition 2 mod 1 is equal to 0, the flag will be incremented. So flag will be 1 and j will be incremented 2. So 2 less than or equal to 2, the condition is 2, again satisfied. So 2 mod 2 is equal to 0. So flag will be, previously flag will be 1, flag will be 2. So now again j plus plus, So j is equal to 3, 3 less than or equal to 2, condition fails. Condition fails. So comes out from the loop. So if flag is equal to 2, so we need not write here else part. So that, so if flag is equal to 2, here the flag is equal to 2, printf 2 is a prime. So here 2 is a prime will be printed. And again I will be incremented, so I is equal to 3 now. So flag is equal to 0, again initialize the flag to 0. Now j is equal to 1, j is equal to 1. So 1 less than or equal to 3, so 3 mod 1, so 3 mod 1 is equal to 0, so automatically flag is incremented. And now j will be incremented to 2, so 3 mod 2, that is equal to 1, so flag will be remain same, j will be incremented to 3, so condition true, so 3 mod 3 is equal to 0, so flag will be incremented to 2, because previously flag is equal to 1. And j is equal to 4 now, so 4 less than or equal to 3, condition fails. So then condition fails, and if flag is equal to 2, that means flag is equal to 2, so the condition also satisfied, the value is also satisfied, so 3 will be printed as a prime, 3 is prime. And now again I will be incremented, so now i is equal to 4, 4 less than or equal to 7, flag is initialized to 0, and j is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 4, so j is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 4, 4 mod 1 is equal to 0, so flag will be 1, and j will be incremented, 4 mod 2 is equal to 0, flag will be incremented 2, j is equal to 3, 4 mod 3 is equal to 1, so flag will not be incremented because it is not 0. So again j is equal to 4, 4 mod 4 is equal to 0, flag will be incremented to 3. So j is equal to 5, now condition fails, and if flag is equal to 2, so here the value of flag is 3, here we are checking the condition as flag is equal to 2, so here the condition fails, so nothing will be happened. Now I will be incremented, so I is equal to 5, so from here also whenever I is equal to 5, the flag will be initialized to 0, and j is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 5, 5 mod 1 is equal to 0, now flag will be 1, and then again j plus plus, now j is equal to 2, so 2 less than or equal to 5, the condition is true, so 5 mod 2 is equal to 1, so the condition fails, again j will be incremented to 3, 5 mod, so 3 is less than or equal to 7, 5 mod 3, that is also not equal to 0, again j plus plus, then j will become 4, 5 mod 4, so 4 less than or equal to 5, the condition is true, and 5 mod 4 not equal to 0, so nothing will be happened, again j will be incremented to 5, so 5 less than or equal to 5, the condition is true, 5 mod 5 is equal to 0, now flag will be incremented, so at 5 mod 1 the flag is incremented to 1, and now 5 mod 5 the flag will be again incremented to 2. Now again j will be incremented to 6, so 6 less than or equal to 5, the condition fails, automatically it will comes out from the loop, and now it will check the value for the flag. So when I is equal to 5, the flag will be, the value of flag will be 2, because the two conditions will be satisfied when 5 mod 1 is equal to 0 and for 5 mod 5 is equal to 0. Now the 5 is prime will be printed. So the process will repeat the same. So this is the outer loop and this is the inner loop. So hope you understood. So nothing complex, very simple. So this is the outer loop. So whenever this condition is false, then only the control will come out from this loop. So until that it will continue the loop. So in that we are writing the inner loop. So whenever this condition is false, then only the control will come out from the loop, and the loop variable will be incremented. So the same procedure will be found, and finally we have to check for the value of a flag. If the flag value is 2, that implies that number is a prime number, because only the prime number will be having the two conditions, two cases to be satisfied, that is for prime number n mod 1 is equal to 0 and n mod n is equal to 0. So only it will be having the factors of 1 and n. So hope you understood this prime series. So this program will display all the prime numbers in between 1 and n. So not the prime count, it will display the series of a prime numbers in between 1 and n. So hope you understood. And if you are having any doubts regarding this prime series or prime numbers, so please feel free to post your doubts in the comment section so that I will clarify your doubts. And if you like my videos, subscribe to my channel and share my videos with your friends. Thank you for listening, and thank you very much.